Hello everyone. In this video, we're gonna see how to create or how to add these bubble plastic wrap effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. All right, so let's get to it. All right, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then let's go to File, New, and I will put 4,000 pixels for the width and 3,000 for the height. In the resolution, I will keep it 72 and press OK. All right, now I want to make this as a photo template, which means that I can go back and apply the same effect on any other image that I want without having to repeat all of this. And to do that, we're gonna use a smart object. So let's create a new layer and let's rename it to image. And then I will right click on this layer and I will convert it to smart object. Now I'll right click again on it in here and I will choose edit content. And this will allow me to actually put the image or whatever I want in here. So I will go and open the image I want to use. And let's make it bigger. And I will press OK. All right, now I'm gonna close this and then I will make sure to press yes to save the changes as we did to our smart objects. And then let's delete this background. All right, now I'm gonna create a copy by pressing Ctrl Command J and this will duplicate it. And let's call this top layer. And let's hide this for now by one click on this eye icon. And then I will go back to the main image and I want to apply a blur on it first, so we'll go to filter, blur, and choose Gaussian blur. Now you can go whatever amount you want for the blurring here. For me, I would keep it between 20 and 25, and I will press OK. All right, the other thing that I want to do is actually to put down the exposure a little bit. So I will go to image, adjustment, and I will choose exposure. And in the exposure, I will make it like -1. Something like that, or -0.8 in this case, and I will press OK. Next, I want to apply a little bit of contrast, so I will go back to Image, Adjustment, and I will choose Brightness and Contrast. And I will put up the contrast a little bit to maybe 20, and I will press OK. And that will be all the effect that we're gonna do for this. Now this layer or this image, it will be actually the down part that it will be below the bubble wrap, so that's why it needs to be a little bit blurred and a little bit down in the exposure. All right, so let's go and actually open the bubble texture. Now this one I created using some images that I took from some plastic bubble wrap. I'm planning to add more, or I'm planning to take more. As you can see, I made a hole and actually I merged these three of them to create this. But I will make sure to upload this texture in here for you guys so you can use it. But if you want the main photo template that it will have more than one plastic bubble wrap, you can find it in my Patreon. All right, so we'll take it and open it in here. And then I will make it bigger to fit. And let's put down the opacity a little bit to see where I want to put this. Maybe the hole, it will be looking good right here. Yeah, I think it looks really cool. All right. Now, before we're gonna actually change the blending mode of this, I want first to make a selection of this black spot that we have in here, or a hole. So to do that, we're gonna keep it simple by just using the magic wand tool. And the main idea in here is to use a low tolerance, maybe 5 in here, and make sure that contiguous in here is checked, and also add to selection is checked. And then I will one click and I would keep clicking until I have a decent selection. Now if we have points like this, we don't have actually to select all of them. We can just go to the layer mask that we're gonna apply and actually delete them. So let me make sure to actually select this part and this one too. And let's see if we have another black hole, maybe this one. Yeah, I think this would work. Now, while we have the selection here, let's go actually and make this top image that we have, make it visible. And then we're gonna apply this as a layer mask. And this is basically what we're gonna see. This one, it will be clear. And the other one, that it will be below the plastic bubble in here. It would have a little bit of blur and everything. All right, so now let's go back to our texture. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of it to screen or linear dodge. And let's go for screen for now. And there we go, you can see how really cool it looks. Now you can choose between the blending modes in here, it's up to you. But for this one, I think I will keep it screen. I like how it looks in this area, and also the lights, just perfect. Now I want to apply a little bit of exposure on this image that is on top. So I will go to filter, and this time I will go for camera raw filter because I want to apply a little bit of grain too. So in the light in here, I will put down a little bit the exposure and boost the contrast a little bit, maybe a little bit of highlight. Yeah, that would be all. For the effects, I think I'm gonna boost a little bit the texture to be more, actually more visible in the details. Yeah, something like that. And then I will go directly to the grain, and I will add maybe 7 in the grain, and I will press OK. And that would be all what we're gonna do for this. All right, so we're almost done. Now the only thing that I want to do is to add a little bit of adjustment, but let's add a little bit of noise first. So let's create a new layer and call it noise. And then I will go to edit and choose fill. And I will make sure that in the content is set to 50% gray, and I will press okay. Now I will go back to filter, and this time I will go to noise and I will add noise. Now this is up to you of the amount of noise that you want. For me, I will change it to uniform, and I will keep the monochromatic check, and I will keep it 5%, and I will press OK. And then I will change the blending mode of this to overlay, and maybe put down the opacity to around 70%. Now the other thing that I want to add is a level adjustment. So I would go and choose levels, and I would play in the midtones a little bit, and a little bit of highlight, and I think it looks really cool. All right, something like that. All right, now let's add one more adjustment. So let's go and add a color lookup, and let's choose something warm, maybe this soft warming look. And then we're gonna put down the opacity to like 70%. And of course, you can add as many adjustments as you want. For me, I think I will stick with this, and that would be our effect. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.